Using aggressive behavior positively is to learn how to put on an act of aggression without subjecting ourselves to the aggressive emotions. Right? Because aggressive emotions primarily constitute hurting another person, which obviously, because the reaction will come back to you, you hurt yourself in the process. So one way to learn how to deal aggressiveness positively is to make a note of what constitutes aggressive behavior. Learn to put on an act without getting into the emotional flow, which obviously constitutes constantly revisiting the intent. Is the intent to hurt another person? Stop. Take a deep breath, count till 10, then continue the communication, because then you know the intent has shifted. You need to come back to your original intent to get work done.
Control the state of aggression, mm-hmm. That purpose is not defeated.
Yes, because the purpose needs to keep coming back to you.
Well, the communication is not defeated.
Yes. Because the only purpose of aggression is to hurt. There is no other way to it.
The purpose is to improvise the situation.
Mm-hmm.
It is going to be assertive only.
Definitely. Yes?
No, the point was the urge to win.
Hmm?
You put up an act of aggression.
The urge to win.
No, the way the competition here, the
okay.
Definition should be accepted.
Right.
In an act of aggression, it is not negative.
Okay. Now, again, when you're talking of the whole concept of winning or victory, the underlying theme is to make others lose. Right? And there, obviously, the aggression naturally comes in. So, again, another thing to revisit is, what is our idea of winning? Is it winning against ourselves in the sense of being better than what we were internally before? Or is it winning against others? Yes, or is it putting down someone? So, putting down, yes. So,
it's activity to excel.
Mm-hmm. Excel, but, well, excelling as against yourself is a good thing, but excelling versus others, yes, that constitutes aggression. So that's where we need to relook our attitude towards victory or winning. What does victory mean to us?
In this case, it was defending our definition. One point about the information. Then, as they say,
by expert,
you can write one thing expert.
Definitely.
And now, one thing you can
write. Yes, a natural thing, because the immediate response is that of reflection.
The other person, in that first scenario, he will look because of supplication. The other person, because of love, willingness is there.
Mm-hmm.
That's the difference.
Right.
You have to just
express. Right.
Another person is accepting. You don't have to be top on your voice.
Yes.
You have to be there.
So again, coming back to intent, that's one thing that we need to train ourselves to do while we communicate in situations that are high on emotions. Keep revisiting your intent, which means a couple of things that we need to take care of are slowing down the way we speak. Because the moment we slow down, we have time to think. And we obviously speak at a much slower rate than at the rate that we think in. So if we further slow down the rate of speech, we obviously have time to go back, think about why is it that we are communicating. And that will definitely reflect in terms of our behavior. So point one is, aggression, the label can be used positively, so it's certainly not a negative label, provided we use it with a certain intent without flowing into the emotion of aggression. Aggression can be used as a tool, right? Which constitutes assertion. Yes. Yes.
I know that what I'm thinking is correct. Then the other person is not even ready to get it. Then in that case, when I keep on saying the example, then I feel
frustrated.
Not even trying to understand what I'm saying. So obviously, in that case, I want to say
this. Yes, but then go on to the aggressive mode while being aware of it. That's what we mean by using aggression positively. Don't get into aggression out of frustration, get into aggression with an intent that the moment the convincing is done, you're back into being assertive and you also explain to the person why you behave the way you behave. Right? So the person knows that the intent in those few minutes was not to hurt, but to convince. Right? Okay, so summarizing this is the fact that aggression can be positive, certainly not a negative label. So let's try and use our intent to use aggression as a tool leading to assertion. Right? Coming to passive aggression, what is passive aggressiveness? High BP possible, yeah, that's a possible repercussion of it. But what is passive aggression?
You ask the question and the
person acts dumb.
Okay.
Silently,
go away, go away.
Through body language.
Okay. Now, yes, we are saying that passive aggression constitutes a certain amount of silence, but how is it different from submission?
No, they don't submit.
So, how is it different? How are these two different?
What has happened is
not taking part. Submission is giving to the other person.
Yes. Passive is refusing to be a part of the communication at all. Submission is, yes, being part of it but not contributing.
Passive aggression is...
Aggression depends on the relationship with situation and... What you expect from the aggression.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What the other person is doing and what effect will it bring on the other person?
Yes, that's what we spoke about in the definition. What is the impact that you wish to have out of the whole communication?
Can
yes.
You say what Praveen Mahajan did to Pramod Mahajan was a passive aggression?
Certainly. It was a complete act of passive aggression where typically passive aggression tends to build up. Because you do not speak, but there comes a threshold level beyond which you cannot hold your emotion, and then obviously it has to erupt violently. There is no other choice to it.
Right?
Yes. It's a reaction to your own aggression.
Right?
So in that sense, if you're talking of emotional aspects of behavior, between aggression and passive aggression, aggression is a healthier way. Because at least you let out steam, right? Whereas passive aggression definitely in health terms hurts you a lot. In terms of relationships, it can be completely devastating. Distances are widened. If you look at aggressors, typically there is a lot of eye contact to the extent of staring, glaring. Whereas if you look at passive aggression, there is possibly no eye contact at all. The person may choose to look away, body language is closed, the legs are closed because the person does not want to communicate but at the same time does not give in. Stubbornness is an aspect of it.
Passive aggression is exploding. Aggression is exploding.
Yes, very well put. Aggression is an immediate explode whereas passive aggression keeps storing. It's almost like a volcano. The lava keeps building up till the time it has to erupt. And then obviously the effects are disastrous.
There's only one exception to whatever you are saying. That is Mahatma Gandhi's satyagraha.
How will you label it? If you had to.
It is passive, it is aggression, but it is positive and healthy.
Right, which means what was the difference there?
Yes.
That's a very good example. What was, how was passive aggression used there?
Protest in the form of bringing out people and bringing the government to a standstill.
Right. So that is what happened. Now here again, understand passive aggression used as a tool. Passive aggression was used as a tool. He was not by nature, Mahatma Gandhi by nature was not passive aggressive. There was a lot of assertion in terms of the thought. If we read Gandhi, there was a clarity of intent. But given that aggression did not work from what was observed in the wars, passive aggression came in as a tool. The way we spoke of using aggression as a tool, passive aggression can be used as a tool in a situation where you know that aggression will only lead to worsening it. It could possibly lead to physical violence in certain situations. For example, if you talk of let's say you talk of a meeting at work, okay, where there are completely opposing views and any other contradictory view will possibly just lead to a deadlock. In that case, passive aggression can be again used as a tool effectively. The only hitch here being passive aggression takes time to take effect.